atheists are rarely represented in the media, and when they are, it doesn't tend to be in a good light. So I thought, let me search YouTube, see if there's any atheists who look like me, who perhaps had some similar perspectives to mine. And yeah, there were a few here and there, but the video that stood out the most to me during my search was a video called The Problem with Black Atheism. Now, I didn't know that Black Atheism had its own subcategory, and I also didn't know that there was this ongoing issue with Black Atheism that needed to be addressed. So I thought, let me check out this video and see what's going on. The video was uploaded by a channel called What Do You Mean, run by a guy named John. And in this video, he was joined by Adam of True ID, which is another apologetics channel. So let's see what they have to say.
So on social media these days, I've noticed a lot lately that you have these new communities of black atheists. And there's these communities of black people that are atheists, and they're starting to come together, and there's groups that are created for them. And I'm sitting here with Adam Coleman from True ID, and we're just going to talk about that a little bit real quick. So Adam, in your estimation, where do you think this kind of new wave of black atheism has come from?
Well, yeah, I think you said it just right. It's a new wave, you know, and I think that to be fair to my black atheist friends out there, you know, it's not to say that there's, you know, has never been black atheists out there, although they've been a super small minority of the African-American community. But you can look to people like James Baldwin from back in the day, who's a writer coming out of the Harlem Renaissance, is very popular during the, you know, during the 60s in terms of when he was publishing his work. He was an outright atheist, you know.
Now, as much as I would love to claim James Baldwin as an atheist, especially since he was one of the most quotable leaders during the civil rights movement, he didn't ever publicly declare himself as one. He did, however, describe himself as non-religious, which could mean a plethora of things, including still maintaining a belief in God. Yes, he was strongly critical of religion, as shown when he said, "If the concept of God has any validity or any use, it can only be to make us larger, freer, and more loving. If God cannot do this, then it is time we got rid of him." But what this shows me is that they haven't fully researched the history of black atheists, and highlights a deeper reason as to why they made this video. Research has shown African Americans have a long history of being represented negatively in media. It's a hangover from slavery in the Jim Crow era. News channels created a narrative that portrayed African Americans as lazy, violent individuals that were prone to crime. And despite the inaccuracies, this media misrepresentation has been shown to cause cultural stigma and create an environment that perpetuates these behaviours. It's quite easy for these stigmas to be internalised within people of the race being misrepresented, and that's why a video like this exists. Now, I'm not saying that it's John's intention to depict black people in a negative light, but if you feel comfortable entitling a video "The Problem with Black Teaching, or Culture, or Parenting, or Music, or Atheism," you have probably fallen into the systemic trap that has been used to limit black folk. I would never make a video called "The Problem with Black Christians or Apologists," because the fact that they are black is of no relevance in the discussion. Now, going back to the James Baldwin detail, I can already hear people saying, look, it's a minor detail that can be overlooked. But an argument can fall based on historical facts being unverified. It's important that we know as atheists who we can bring up in discussion as our representatives. Some of our most famous figures currently being Arian Foster and Thandi Newton, and our most outspoken and influential being Mandisa Thomas, the founder and president of Black Nonbelievers Inc. Sikivu Hutchinson, an author and playwright who became the first African-American woman to have a book published about atheism. Graydon Square, a popular atheist rapper and producer. And these are just a select few of many black atheists that they could have mentioned in their video if they had done further research on the topic. And this is exactly why I hope to be one of many black voices in the atheist community. Videos like this come out and they become the only perspective widely available. Let's create some balance online and engage in a positive discourse so we can empower black people as a whole, rather than tearing down one group to uplift another. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. This has been Apart from the Obvious. Keep setting yourself apart. I'll see you soon.